to announce the poll schedule, right? So at the outset, on behalf of the Commission, I would like to apologize to friends from media for inconvenience caused by shifting of the press conference timing from 12:30 to 3 o'clock. This was necessitated because of certain compulsions. One of the states had to publish electoral roll finally on 8th of October, and we had a meeting with Director General CDAC, who are our technology experts, to resolve whatever difficulties they were facing till late evening, and it was thought that their engineers will be able to sort this out within 2 days and by 8th it will be published. But this morning, after their assessment, it emerged that it will take more time. That is one. Second, there is a case pending with Honorable High Court about the electoral roll, and Honorable High Court had ordered that first the final roll must be shown to them on 8th, that is Monday, only then it should be finally published. And third issue was, we will be giving you a press note for some by-elections. So third thing came just before I was leaving home from the Chief Secretary of a state, that because of certain forecasts, those by-elections should not be announced today and we should wait for all those cyclone or something, whatever it is. And then another issue from that state was about a petition, election petition, which we thought, because of the candidate who was elected having been expired, that this petition doesn't survive. But it emerged that the petitioner filed a case again, that because it was fault in nomination, so if nomination was rejected, he should have been declared elected. So the date has been fixed for 23rd October, yesterday only. So that, all those things made us to change everything, like date of final publication from 8th to 12th, this order was passed and it is on our website now, you can see. So all these issues compelled us to complete this. There has been speculation and some political statements also. For that I just have to say that politicians and political parties are political creatures and they have to see politics in everything because of their inherent nature. We have no comments to make on that. Now, friends, the terms of legislative assemblies of Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Mizoram are due to expire on Chhattisgarh, 5th January 2019, number of seats is 90. Okay. Chhattisgarh, the term is expiring on 5th of January 2019 and number of seats there is 90. Madhya Pradesh, term is expiring on 7th January 2019 and the number of seats is 230. Rajasthan tenure is coming to an end on 20th January 2019 and number of seats is 200. Mizoram, the term is coming to an end on 15th December 2018 and number of seats is 40. And all these four states have been going to polls simultaneously, 15th December. So Commission is required to hold general elections according to the law to all these states because they are to be held together before 15th of December. In the meanwhile, you may all be aware that the state of Telangana dissolved the state legislative assembly prematurely. And as per the reference number 1 of 2002 to Honorable Supreme Court and their opinion thereon, it is incumbent on the commission to hold the election as soon as possible and on the first occasion, but not later than 6 months. And therefore, that is also due. Electoral rolls, you may be aware that for all poll going states, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Mizoram, the publication finally took place for 3 states on 27 September, and Rajasthan needed 1 day extension, so it happened on 28th of September. As regards Telangana, I have already told you that earlier it was scheduled to be published finally on 8th after showing to the Honorable High Court, but since the engineers and our officials there have assessed that it is going to take more time, so Commission has ordered that now it will be finally published on 12th of October. 12. You may be aware that Commission distributes photo voter slips as a identity document. This will be done as per our convention. But in addition to that, Braille photo voter slip will also be given, because this year's Commission's theme is accessible elections. And as per the recommendation during national convention, national consultation on accessibility, we have started giving APICs also in Braille and photo voter slips also in Braille. Voter guide will be given to every voter. Assured minimum facilities are already in these 4 states available to the extent of 100% in 3 and 99 point some percentage in remaining 2 states. Voter assistance booth will be set up at every polling station, because earlier these kiosks used to be set up by the political parties and these were creating a lot of problems, and therefore Commission had taken a call that the expenditure on these kiosks will be added to the candidates' expenditure account, and therefore now political parties are hesitant in setting up those booths. So Commission has started setting up voter assistance booth. All women managed polling stations, minimum 1 per legislative assembly will be set up, all women polling station, where even the security forces will be all women. As regards electronic voting machines and voter verifiable paper audit trail, the whole process as is done earlier, or as was done earlier, first randomization, then second randomization, all those processes will be gone through. And for your information, in all these states, all the machines being used are Mark III, M3. These are the latest produced at Bharat Electronics and ECIL. VVPAT slip count shall remain 1 randomly selected polling station in each assembly constituency. Mock poll will be conducted at every polling station before the start of poll. Electronically transmitted postal ballot system, this has been in vogue since 2016. It will be available to all service voters and all our officers posted in the missions abroad. And you will be happy to note that most of the officials in the mission have enrolled because of this facility. As regards affidavits of the candidates, we have suggested certain changes in the form of affidavit to Law Ministry based on the order of Honorable Supreme Court of India recently in decriminalization of politics. Those changes, as soon as find place in the system, will be applicable, will be made applicable. This will cater to even the need for advertising, as has been ordered by Honorable Supreme Court, that candidate will also advertise or sort of have 3 insertions in print as well as 3 times in electronic media. And party will also do it. So that information which will be included in this affidavit will be taken for that. Model code of conduct. Model code of conduct will come into force in these four states, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Mizoram and Chhattisgarh, with effect from today after this announcement. And in Telangana, if you remember, Election Commission had taken a call that in such cases it will come into force on the day assembly is dissolved, because it's a caretaker government and elections are imminent, so model code of conduct must apply immediately on premature dissolution. Videography, webcasting, CCTV coverage will be done as usual, which used to be done. CAPF will be deployed for ensuring peaceful conduct of poll on all critical, sensitive and vulnerable areas, polling stations. Measures to prevent public nuisance. There have been many petitions to the Election Commission that please take care of environment and ask the parties, candidates to use eco-friendly substances for preparing election campaign material, etc. And this is our call to ask the parties and candidates to follow this. Law and order and deployment of forces. You will be very happy to know that this time commission reviewed in the states that what happened to all those cases which were registered during last elections, 2013 elections and 2014 Lok Sabha elections. And to our surprise, we found that in most states, conviction rate was high. In fact, Karnataka was very high last election. Even in Madhya Pradesh, it was very high. And that acts as a deterrent against the troublemongers in the next election. Commission is committed that all weaker sections, including SCs, STs, and disabled, will be provided all facilitation and all kinds of protection to come out and participate in the poll. Election expenditure monitoring, extensive and comprehensive instructions for the purpose have been issued. Flying squads, strategic surveillance teams, investigation directorate of Income Tax Department, etc., at airport, air intelligence units, all these things have been tied up and a comprehensive enforcement will be taken care of there. And another application, C-Vigil, you may be aware, Citizen Vigilance. This has been launched, and in fact it was tested in Karnataka polls in Bangalore city. This is empowering the voter, empowering the common man to photograph or to video anything wrong in violation of MCC happening. Liquor distribution, money distribution, freebie distribution, or any hate speech, anything. They can just photograph and upload and send. And within a time frame, our flying squad, our police station, or our machinery will take action, respond to them that your ID number is this and this action is being taken. There is a provision also for hiding your identity in case you are taking on some very powerful person or powerful party. This will be available only after the poll is announced and around 7-8 days after the notification. Ceiling on election expenditure, as you may be aware, that it is 28 lakhs for all assembly constituencies except for in Mizoram and Telangana. No, Mizoram, which is 20 lakhs. Media engagement. The Commission has always considered the media as an important ally and a potent force multiplier in ensuring an effective and efficient election management. Hence, Commission has directed all the CEOs, all the DEOs of all poll-going states to continuously brief the media about the progress, about all the arrangements, so that public comes to know through the media. Media certification and monitoring committees are in place, and they will certify all advertisements to electronic media. And last 2 days, 48 hours before the closing of poll, even the print media. Monitoring of electronic and social media, I think we have already said a lot about this. Sweep programs are going on, and especially our focus this year is facilitating all the persons with disabilities to enroll and also to come out and vote, so that every voter comes out and vote and no voter is left behind. Observers will be deployed, general, police and expenditure observers. In addition, accessibility observers will also go to these states. New IT applications, I have already mentioned CVigil, Suvidha for giving permission of public meeting, etc. within 24 hours, Samadhan, Sugam, and these other IT applications, these will be deployed in these elections. On poll day, our EMMC will furnish us all the monitoring reports, and we will be getting the inquiry from the field and responding to the media. Conduct of officials. Commission has already conveyed very firmly that conduct of all the officials right down to the SHO level will be seen by the Commission, and any partisan activity on the part of anyone will be dealt with most sternly. So they must all act in total non-partisan manner till the election. Commission is committed to maintain purity of elections and to deliver free, fair and transparent elections. Commission would like to make an appeal to all media, civil society groups, political parties and public at large to become partners in strengthening the process of conducting free, fair, peaceful elections. Now I will come to schedule. First phase will be Chhattisgarh, LWE affected area, that is southern part of Chhattisgarh. There, notification will be issued on 16th October. Last date of nomination will be 23rd October. Scrutiny of nominations, 24th October.
The last date of nomination
will be 23rd October.
There have been mass pledges being taken place and panchayats are being taking resolutions to support one party or the other party. Does that interact the model code of conduct? And what is your objection?
Panchayats are
mass pledges are being taken place.
Okay. We'll take note of this and we'll see. Though in a democratic process, whatever people decide, that should prevail.
Sir, I could add saying that. We are however of the view that the voters list should not be notified in any mode before this matter is further considered on the basis of the response of the ECA, and any officer under it.